My name is Zohir Chaudhary, and today we'll talk about sea level rise. So what is sea level rise? A sea level rise is an increase in global mean sea level as a result of an increase in the volume of water in the world's ocean. And in this image, you can see sea level, present sea level, projected sea level by 2030, and projected sea level by 2050, just to give an idea of the projection of sea level over time. And actual data has been collected from quite a while, and the data shows a progressive sea level rise over time. And you can see that as the time progresses, especially in the last 20 some years or so, sea level has been rising much more rapidly as compared to the past. In fact, from 1993 to 2017, sea level has risen about 82 millimeter, which is approximately 3.4 millimeter per year, and that's confirmed by satellite data, as compared to 1910 to 1990, where the mean sea level has risen just by about 1.5 millimeter per year. So presently, sea level is rising much, much faster than in the past. So what is the cause of the sea level rise? In this picture, you can see quite a few different causes. Among glaciers melting, thermal expansion, and ice sheet melting. These three are very important. However, ocean thermal expansion is the most important one. The reason is that as the temperature rises, the water molecule in the ocean starts expanding, and they require more space. And as they expand and require more space, sea level starts rising. So this is what thermal expansion of ocean mean. Current and projected sea level rise. In here, you can see the sea level rise from the past and sea level rise more or less in the present and in the last 1993 to 2010 years. And you can see that thermal expansion by far has been the most dominant, and followed by the other one listed in here, among them glaciers, except in Greenland and Antarctica, because they're melting so fast, they're leading to significant sea level rise. Overall, if you add all of this up, you're getting about 2.8 millimeter per year sea level rise. As we move forward in here, you can see that there are different scenarios that are getting projected. Some scenarios are very conservative, and they're estimating approximately half a meter of sea level rise. Other scenarios are showing that sea level could rise as much as 1 meter or even more. And what is the potential sea level rise? So the cryosphere, as we mentioned earlier, is that part of the Earth that is covered with ice. So as the cryosphere starts melting, we can see that all the ice that is stored in the various components of the cryosphere, if that were to melt, how much sea level would rise. So we could see in here that the greatest sea level rise would come from here, which is the ice sheets over Greenland and over Antarctica. Antarctica ice sheets melting would lead to approximately 57 meter of sea level rise, as compared to the melting of the Greenland ice sheets, which would lead about 7 meter. So this would, the consequences from here would be devastating. All of the cities that are located next near the coastal areas would be facing significant problems. Many of them would go underwater if this were to happen. On the other hand, melting of the sea ice, if you remember, does not lead to sea level rise. Melting of the seasonally frozen ground in the northern hemisphere does not lead to sea level rise, as well as melting of ice sheets does not lead to sea level rise. So let's do a quick concept check. Which of the following components not cause sea level rise when melted? That's correct. So sea ice is ice on the ocean. So if this melts, will not lead to sea level rise. And ice shelf as well they are will not lead to sea level rise, so A and B, which is two of the above. That concludes our lecture. Thank you.